Hello there, all you amazing people. I just came home from a walk, and that's dangerous because you start to think, and thinking is not good for the human spirit or the human race, as far as I can see from anything going and everything going on in this world, is that the thoughts not good. Especially if it's thoughts that I don't have, you know, like as an individual. You don't like my thoughts because they don't align with your thoughts, therefore we cannot talk to each other. That's how the world is. You may look at this. Operating system, share. Linux, AIX, this is for supercomputers, by the way. This is not the desktop, but it kind of highlights something I want to talk about. What if this was desktop operating systems? What if Linux was 84% of the desktop market? Before I go into that, comment, like, subscribe, go on to my Discord, give me video suggestions of videos you want me to do, because then you cannot be angry about me not talking about something, because I will make that video 9 out of 10 times. When you've done all of that, let's continue this video. First, before I go into how the world's going to look like, I have to set up some back ideas you have to think about. You cannot expect the world to just change into how you want it to be because your favorite OS is the primarily desktop OS. What I mean by that is companies, businesses, people are going to do the same things that they are doing today that they did in the past on that system. And I will go into a little bit more of an explanation later on. But remember that. You are not going to change people's habits, people's wants, people's desires, people's need if Linux was the primary OS. And this is what history tells us. There was a time where there was no real proprietary OS. It was all up there, you know. Nobody really cared about proprietary or non-licensed or licensed software. And people still do the same shit they do today. They're still idiots, they're still malicious, they're still trying to rip you off. All of that is still going to happen, okay? Remember that. We fast forward next year. Microsoft CEO is being caught doing the dirty with a donkey and a monkey. Everyone don't like that because apparently he don't have a average size ding-dong. So therefore, we all revolting against him and his tiny little unusable Windows operating system, because, you know, we all know that real men with big dongs only use OSs built by other people with big dongs. So we are all revolting. Whole society is like, you know what? That tiny little ding-dong man, we don't want to have anything to do with him. We go all Linux. Companies follow. The year after that, 2026, it must be. God, time flies. We are all running Linux. So what is going to happen? Are we going to have this, like, amazing world where every user is a computer literate, a computer expert that are helping out communities and fixing codes and bugs and helping Linux become a better Linux? A game company stopping to become super anti-consumer along with, like, software suites like Adobe and stuff like that? The really, really short answer is no. No. It's going to be exactly as it is today. The only difference in the whole computing world is that instead of using Linux to provide those crazy shit, they are using Linux. And you may say, oh, well, Linux don't take telemetry. Yeah, not now. But someone will make a super great Linux operating system. Super great Linux operating system. And they will take telemetry on. You see, oh, nobody wants to use that. Well, most people don't want, let me put it another way, most people want the Macintosh or the Windows experience. They don't want the Linux experience that we're giving them today. They want basically a Linux Windows or a Linux Mac, for lack of a better word. They want Linux to function or do for them the same shit Windows and Mac do. And they don't give a fuck if that then means telemetry. Who is probably going to be the, well, not person, but group that can do that? Someone with a lot of money that can have a lot of pull in the industry, then get, you know, big corporations to play nicely with them. So that means that you are getting a proprietary company or a company with millions and billions of dollars making those kind of Linux distributions that the vast majority of Linux users want. And they are going to take telemetry. They're probably also going to put some proprietary bits and bobs in there. They are more than likely also going to do shit that only work under their Linux distribution. Why? Because it makes give them a competitive edge. Canonical do that today. SUSE do that today. Red Hat do that today. Why? Because why should they then use their respective Linux distributions? Linux distributions today are doing that exact that. There are things that only work under certain Linux distributions that are built into the core of the Linux distribution. These massive companies or organizations are going to do that. And I know what you will say, Kent, you fool. You don't get it. It will be open source, a lot of it, so we can just take that shit out and run our own systems or make our own version of it. That's great. And you are right. But you have to remember one thing. The biggest Linux distribution, or the Linux distribution that you want to fork off, because it gives the users everything they want, but it's also doing that stupid fucking shit, taking your data and telemetry and stuff like that. But they have way more money than you. They have way more developers than you have. Or the alternative little fork have. So that means that the fork, and this is happening right now in the real world, by the way, the fork is always going to play catch-up. The fork is not going to implement new features. The fork is not going to be on the forefront on innovation. They don't have the time and money for it. But the new Linux, but the big, you know, big dog Linux distro that do all those bad things, they have that. They have research and development departments. They have user groups to probe the users on how to use or what they want and stuff like that. So every time they come out with a release, they have a lot of new features. The fork may have one or two features the main distro don't have. And then they have to play catch up. They will always be behind. You see that all the time nowadays. What is the real difference between Mint and Ubuntu, besides a few little programs? The desktop environment. Do Mint or Sorian and all of these distributions, do they release their main distro the same day Ubuntu released their main distro? Most don't, because they are playing catch-up. Yes, they are adding some things Ubuntu don't have. Not all the time, but sometimes. But they have to wait for Ubuntu to get their shit together. So Ubuntu is always 1, 2, 3, 4 steps behind. Oh, sorry, not behind. In front. See, I can't think. Thinking too much about the Microsoft CEO with his little ding-dong. But Ubuntu will always be ahead. It will always be ahead. And the distributions that are based on Ubuntu are dependent on Ubuntu. They need Ubuntu. So if you're forking this massive popular Linux distribution, you are depending on it. You need that company to exist. I know people like Mint are experimenting with having the Linux Debian edition, Linux Mint Debian edition, which is great, but it's inferior in so many places to the mainline Ubuntu-based system, mostly because they don't focus that much on it. But that also means that, let's say Ubuntu just disappear tomorrow. They need to migrate over to the Linux Debian, Mint Debian edition. A lot of users will feel like they're getting a lesser quality. They're getting a lesser good product because it's not up to snuff with their main distribution. So for 1 or 2 years or releases or how, you know, some of that nature, a lot of people be angry and disenfranchised and stuff like that. And this is not just with Linux distribution. Do you think Adobe, let's say everyone is running Linux, you know, 90%, now we are 90%. Is running Linux. Do you think Adobe is going to open source their programs? No. They're just making it work under Linux. Do you think any company right now that has a business model are going to open source their programs to run on Linux? Because they don't have to run on Linux. You can run all the proprietary software you want on Linux. No, they are not. The only thing that you are changing that is going to change is the host, the OS. The rest of the world is going to function exactly the fucking same as it is today. Adobe is trying to take your kidneys, your testicles, your buttholes, and then you have to pay them to do it also. They will go do that under Linux. You will not get a better computing world if Linux was the majority of the market share. When when not AMD, when Amiga and Commodore was ruling the home computer market, we still had the things going on we have today, just in a smaller selection of what you will call it, because home computing was not that big back then. But there were companies doing the same shit that they're doing under Windows in the Amiga days and in the Commodore 64 days and the Atari days. There were gaming companies trying to rip you off. Look at the whole, like, what is like, was it E.T.? The game that was like built in a week and just was a cash crab. It don't matter what hosting platform a system is based on. Companies and people are going to do the same shit. And because they don't have to open source it, you won't noticing it. And here's another thing. Even if they open source it, they will still, again, because they have more money, more resources, they will still be 10 steps or 1,000 steps ahead of the community or the people that are trying to do the good things. Another good example is all the Red Hat alternatives. You know, like the CentOS's and stuff like that. They take Red Hat and take all the proprietary and all the branding out of it. But there are still a lot of people that just go with Red Hat. And they are not really providing anything to the world other than a cheaper version of Red Hat, which a lot of people want. Let's not forget that CentOS was almost used or was used more than Red Hat Enterprise Linux was. That was why they canned the traditional CentOS, which again, I don't understand why no Linux YouTuber was massively angry about that. The world is not going to change. You are not getting a better OS. You are not getting a more secure OS, because that's another thing. If Linux become this big, you now need to run antiviruses. You need to run firewalls. Because every fucking idiot that wants to take your shit is going to attack you. This has been proven. They would have an easier time with it because they can see the source code just like you can. And then again, we're playing cat and mouse like they do today. But if you talk to security experts, they will tell you that open source systems have some of the best malware best malware and viruses in the world. The best. Like, it's the best fucking most efficient and best coded malware and viruses in the world that is being made for open source operating systems. Because they don't have to guess. They don't have to play a lot of ifs and maybes. They can exactly tailor their malware, whatever it is, to target a specific distribution or system. And I know, you say, oh, well, people can fix it because they, you know, it's open source. We have had bugs in the kernel, in other software, in Linux, that has been there for over a decade, sometimes almost 2 decades. More developers or more users don't mean that they are being found faster, because more users will mean more developers, which mean more development, which mean more lines of code, which mean more complicated software, which mean more software. So the developer to looking at the code ratio is going to be the same. Because most people, even most developers, don't want to sit and bug fix or buff overflow hunting code in the spare time. I've talked to hundreds of developers now. And I don't think I've met one that sits after work for 8 hours a day or even 3 hours a day just for fun with a cup of coffee or beer or whatever, like a little joint in their fucking face, and just be like, you know what? I want to scout out this code for like the next 3 or 4 hours. What developers do is they fix shit that they, you know, they find, you know. So if they're using a program and there's something wrong with it, they will fix it. But they don't sit and actively look for problems. That's, companies do that. There are companies in the world that get money for doing that. But the world is not going to change. I don't know what you all expect if Linux takes over the world. We will still have the Ubisoft, the Blizzards, we will still have the EAs of the world. And no matter open or closed source, you cannot keep up with them. And you see, oh, just make alternatives. Yeah, there are many, again, if you take Blizzard, there are many MMO alternatives to World of Warcraft. But they are almost never being played. There are many, many, many alternatives to Overwatch, to Diablo. There's many, 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 many alternatives to, well, not Madden, because that's a licensed game, but you know, you get what I'm coming at here. And in a few instances, you can see those alternatives be more popular than the quote-unquote main game. But most of the time, most people, they play the things coming out from the big companies, because it's what they know. It knows how to get people addicted. It knows how to get people FOMO. Linux people are so delusional about what Linux is for people that it's not even funny. Because Linux, well, an OS, this is the best way of explaining it. An OS is, like a lot of people say, it's a translation layer between the human and the computer hardware, which is true. But the way an OS is used nowadays and be made, a OS is nothing more than your Microsoft Store or your Windows Discover or your GNOME software or your App Store on your phone. It's a way to host and deliver content, apps, games. That's what it is. People use their computers as an appliance. For them, it could be macOS, it could be Linux, it could be Windows. They don't give a flying fuck what it is, as long as it gets out of their way and it delivers them the apps they want, the entertainment they want. That's it. That's all they care about. For them, it's just a hosting platform. Until you understand that, you will be delusional in your thinking about how the world's going to look like if Linux takes over the world. All we are getting is a, if you're believing all the Linux world's talk that I've been listening to for close to 30 years of using Linux, all we are getting is a more stable, secure, less telemetry and data collected host. That's all we are getting. And if you check the OS, let's say your average everyday life, your average life, your average day, the amount percentage that the OS takes out of how much data that's being collected from you and telemetry is almost nothing. There are cars that take more telemetry and data from you. Your credit, your bank takes more telemetry and data from you than any OS does. Is it something you should think about? Yes. Is it something that's good to be aware of? Yes. But switching for Linux or from Windows to Linux and think you're getting more private? That's probably the biggest illusion of them all. I know this may sound like a super, super fucking weird thing, but it's the reality of it. Why is it not going to change? Because this is how the world works. This is how the world functions. For Linux to change the world, it has to change the mindset of corporate America, Europe, whatever you'll call it, Asia. It has to change the human nature. It can't. No matter what OS you're using and how open it is, the same with software, there will be people out there with more money, with more knowledge trying to exploit you. There will also be a lot of people out there with more money that are trying to help you. Like I said, it's always, you know, that's what security is, it's a cat and mouse game. But if you think that you will have an advantage for running Linux, nope. You're just taking away a small little part, my friend. Just a small little part. And my prediction is also this, that if it happened that Linux became the 84% tile, most of you people that are running Linux right now are going Haiku or FreeBSD. Because in reality, what you are is a hipster. You mostly only run Linux because it makes you interesting. You run Linux because it makes you unique. It's part of your identity. It's not something everyone else is doing. You're doing something different. The second Linux become mainstream, most of the current Linux users are going somewhere. You see that today with Ubuntu. Oh, why are you using Ubuntu? It's the Microsoft of Linux. It's too popular. A lot of people hate on Ubuntu because it's too popular. It's doing snap packages and forcing it on its user. I just installed Linux Mint on my computer or my laptop. That is forcing me to use flat packages. What's the difference? Elementary OS is forcing me to use flat packages. And you have to remember, the only thing that's proprietary on Snap Packages is the store. Everything else is open source. You can make your own store. It's plain stupid how Linux users think that if everyone used Linux, the world would be a better place. See you all later. Bye-bye.